beautiful darling, the fall and winter 2021 fashion trends are here. Are you ready? These are the 7 wearable trends this season. When I say wearable, that means when you go to a store or shop online, you're gonna see a lot of this everywhere, in everyday kind of stores. But if you happen to be petite, I am 5'2", by the way, some of these are not exactly wearable. Let's find out. The sweater vests. We started seeing this last year, and this season, they've come back and even stronger. You're gonna see more designs and different options at a lot of stores. The most popular ones are gonna be those with detailing and texture. A lot of these are gonna be oversized, and that is gonna be a challenge if you are petite like me. These can be great pieces to wear in transitioning weather. They can look casual, but you can also make them look preppy. The most easy way to wear something like this, wear it by itself. You wanna go with a style that is not too oversized and not too long. If you wanna go for the layering look, that gets a little more complicated, especially if you happen to be short like me. The easiest way to pull off the layering look, tuck in your under layer when you wear it on top of a blouse or button-down shirt. Or you can also wear this on top of a dress. Denim. This season, the overall trend is to go for a more loosely fitted jeans. Wide leg jeans, flare leg jeans, bootcut jeans. This can be a good news if you happen to be petite like me. My number one choice for petite women is always flare leg jeans. If you find the right style, it can totally elongate your legs like nothing else. Wide leg jeans can be one of the best styles if you happen to have a pear-shaped body. But on the other hand, they can also overwhelm you if you happen to be petite. I do have another video on this topic, how to wear wide leg shape. If you have short legs like me, make sure you watch this video as well. Mom jeans, boyfriend jeans, the relaxed fit continue to be on trend. Cheap, what about skinny jeans? There has been so much debate and fight about whether or not skinny jeans are out. So apparently, the Gen Z, the TikTok generation, are ditching the skinny jeans. But I know, I will always be wearing skinny jeans in the winter, especially when the boot season comes around. Nothing works better with tall boots than skinny jeans. Now, are you ready for this? Low-rise jeans are back.
What? Oh.
I know, I can't believe it either. The last time when it was popular, I don't know, 10, 15 years ago, I saw someone in the restaurant, she was sitting down and I saw her underwear. I was traumatized. So I can't believe it, but it's happening. They are bringing it back. It's making an official comeback this season. Who would want to wear low-cut jeans? Someone who has zero belly fat and seriously want to make her legs look shorter. The quilted texture is gonna be everywhere this fall and winter. I adore it. Chanel bags, it's timeless. And this season, you're gonna see them not just with the top designers, but with everyday kind of brands. Besides, they're not only in bags, but also in clothing. Ralph Lauren always make quilted coats every year, but now you're gonna have more options, more affordable. And not just coats, skirts and shoes. I think so chic and classy, and I'm gonna get more of it. This season, we're gonna see a lot of tailored pieces. Structured shoulders, well-fitted, the elongated silhouette. I love it. No matter how tall you are, these are gonna look great. And especially you are petite, these are the best options to elongate our frame and make you look more authoritative, especially in the office environment. After a long period of time working from home, if you are heading back to the office, these are wonderful investment pieces. Wear this to go to the next interview, Or if you're planning on having that conversation with your boss about that raise you deserve, the promotion you've always wanted, this are gonna make you look more sharp and confident. Cropped everything. We've all seen a lot of crop pieces in the summer. That has always been on trend. But this season, you're gonna see a lot of them in the fall and the winter collection as well. Like the cropped cardigan I'm wearing. And we're not just talking about the fast fashion Zara or H&M. We're also talking about Chanel, Armani. They're making this official. This season, the length is getting even shorter. I know this is not for everybody. I personally love anything cropped. Because I'm 5'2 and I have a longer torso, cropped pieces are the best way to elongate my legs and make me look taller. If you do have a midriff concern, I don't like to show my midriff either. There are ways for you to still look good in cropped pieces. I always wear them with high-waisted skirts or high-waisted pants. You can cover everything, nothing is showing. And you still get to enjoy the benefit of elongating your leg with cropped pieces. Sequins. This season, you're gonna see a lot of sequins. And they're not just for nightclubs. These are the pieces that you can wear during the daytime and layer with your everyday kind of clothes. These are the statement pieces that you can wear this season, and they're not just when the holiday season comes around. I think it's fun to play with sequins because we all need a little bit of a reminder the future is bright. It's almost like we're revenge dressing. The past year and a half, a lot of us have been in the lockdown mode and we have not been out and about. Now it's almost like we need it. Our closets craving those sparkles. So this season, sequins are not just reserved for nighttime, not just reserved for the holidays. Wear it when you're going on coffee dates, when you're going on brunches with girlfriends, anywhere, any occasion that you feel like you need to make a statement. Sequins are a wonderful choice. The best way to go for the daytime sequin look, pair it with your most basic pieces. If you have a sequin skirt, pair it with a white t-shirt, white button-down shirt. And you can also go the other way around. If you have a sequin top, you can also pair it with your most basic. The simple combination will make sure they balance out each other and you will not look overdressed for the daytime. This season, you're gonna see a lot of saturated colors. This is so different than before. Most of us dress colorful for the summer. Once the weather starts to turn colder, when the leaves start to fall, we put away our colorful pieces and we switch to neutrals. I used to live in Manhattan. In the fall and the winter, the only colors you see people wearing on the street, blacks, grays, navies, beiges, burgundy at the most. But this year, that is gonna change. This is along the same line as revenge dressing. In this stay-at-home mode for so long, now our closet and us, we're craving bright colors and it does not matter what season it is. If you want to go for the bolder color this season, the easiest way is to go with one bold color at a time. Because color on colors is always a harder thing to do. You can pick up your favorite bright color and pair it with a neutral color. No matter how the fashion trends change every year, one thing is always most critical, especially in the fall and the winter. How do you layer? That is so important because every layer is adding another horizontal line to your body. That's very hard to do, actually, much harder than most of us think. It's especially challenging if you happen to be petite like me. The most flattering way to layer is to pay attention to the proportion. Ancient Greeks have taught us the most pleasant to the eye is the rule of the thirds. And how do you do that? How do you use that in your daily wear? Watch this video. These layering tips changed my life, and they will change yours too.